Currently, she works with a number of international schools in India and abroad as a CEO, advisor, consultant, school leadership coach, and a board member. She set up 14 international, 8 CBSE, and 2 multi-disability centres across India and Doha, Qatar. Maalathi has been constantly campaigning for the upliftment of rural skills and enhancing the standards of education delivered to rural children across India. She avidly advocates that providing high-quality education to all children, irrespective of their socio-economic background, is one of the fundamental ways to propel the nation forward. KR Educational Services, under her guidance, has supported many rural children to complete their school and higher education, and has also empowered numerous women entrepreneurs. I don't know if you might say a few words, please.
செல்வத்துள் செல்வம் செவி செல்வம் மச்செல்வம் செல்வத்துள் எல்லாம் தலை திருவள்ளுவர் சார். I think that coincides very well with the UKTNCC because, you know, either way it makes us rich because we have been listening to quite a lot of speakers and then, you know, it also gives us an opportunity to become wealthy, more and more wealthy. A very good afternoon to everyone. It gives me immense pleasure to be here today as part of the UKTNCC Business Meet. Education and working with children are my life's calling. I am elated to be here talking to you all, talking to the gathering of diplomats, industrialists, policymakers, intellectuals, and game changers about the K-12 education sector in India and the opportunities for collaboration, investment, and development in Tamil Nadu. Maybe that will be an extension of what Mr. Shankar said to TCS. I will add on some more to it. There are over 1.5 million schools in India. In Tamil Nadu alone, there are 5,300 schools and over 100 million students are actively enrolled in school each year. It's not a new knowledge that private educational institutions have contributed immensely to the spread of education across India. In many places where the public sector couldn't reach, private schools have been a beacon of hope to the people and the trustworthy locum for the government. Until now, public-private partnership in the K-12 education sector has been a prodigious success, and I can confidently state that it will continue to be seen in the foreseeable future. Rapid developments that have been happening in the last few years in the education sector in India. In Tamil Nadu, new reforms have been drafted, curriculum and syllabus have been revised, assessment methodologies updated, and teacher eligibility exams have been introduced to refine the quality of teachers. A great deal of opportunities has emerged in the areas of professional teacher training and development, school leadership and management as well. Many private schools are increasingly affiliating to the international boards like the UK's very own Cambridge International Examinations, EdExcel, the IB from the Switzerland and the American system. Of late, there has been a noticeably steep increase in the amount of money expended on the school management by the school management on training and development for their teachers and the institutional leaders. The demand for top quality online teacher education is quite high. With e-learning gaining momentum across the country, professional programs in education is becoming increasingly sought after in both urban and rural settings. And this is one prime area where I see a lot of opportunities for investment. Until now, collaboration in education has happened only in the higher education sector, between universities to be precise. We at KR Educational Services foresee a lot of potential in collaboration happening in the K-12 education sector at this juncture, where the native population is keen on giving their children the international exposure right from their primary years. This would eventually necessitate a systematic change in the way education is perceived and delivered. Student knowledge and exchange programs would be welcomed with open arms. Integration of technology into everyday classes and daily lessons has created a wave of change in how teaching and learning happens in India. In terms of business, a whole new range of educational technological firms are being launched and so many new products are being marketed towards the sector. The United Kingdom has always been a pioneer in the field of education, be it K-12 or higher education, and it is only apparent that technology blended with education much earlier here than anywhere else in the world. I am sure a partnership is effectively integrating technology with education is another main area where a lot of opportunities exist, with immense scope for growth in the future. The education industry around the world continues to grow and demand for high quality assets is high. Niche education consultancy firms in India like ours are keen to explore M&A trends in this sector with input from with input in the form of private equity, venture capitalists and trade investors, as well as companies that have keen on looking out for investment. Education, especially at the school level, is of utmost importance to each of us, no matter what we do and or where we are, because all of us want to offer a strong foundation for our young children. With the entire world becoming one shared network, I'm confident that a great deal of opportunities to grow and expand in the school education sector between UK and India, especially in areas like educational technology, teacher training and development, support services, student knowledge exchange programs, early years education, and M&As. My journey in education became, you know, three decades ago as a teacher. Every day I walked into my classroom with a thought, the future of the world is in my classroom today. This afternoon, I walked into this room with a thought, the future of transcendental education is in the world, is in this room today. I sincerely thank all of you for your time and conclude with the high hopes of establishing a mutually beneficial association in the K-12 education sector between the UK and India, especially with my state, Tamil Nadu. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.